festival's been going on a long time. We're so happy we get to host it and do this every year. It's such an exciting time for our school of music to see these new pieces and these composers and performers come from all over the place to do their thing for us. This concert is called the Altgeld Chamber Players. Now, the Altgeld Chamber Players have come in many shapes and sizes and varieties over the years. It's our school music faculty, and I can't even begin to tell them how thrilled and grateful I am that our faculty have participated in this festival. So today we're just going to hear some music by two of our faculty, Jung-Hwa Lee and Jessica Butler on trombone. She'll start the concert, joined by Jenny Kirby. I hope you enjoy this very much, and I hope that you can come to the rest of the concerts this week. There's some really good stuff going on, so check out the website and the schedule, and hope to see you there. Okay, enjoy the concert.
We tore it up pretty bad over there. Pretty much going to a junkyard, I'ma say it like that, because you got burning cars over here, you got cars with bodies in it, then you got what it takes and ran over the steel rail, you just ran on top of it, then that's bent all up on top of it by the bridge, and it gone over the bridge and had a machinery guns, what he can spin, shoot, man. Blew that up, took off. We tore it up pretty bad over safeties never flew out. Those were the ones we had to worry about. basically all it took was a slight movement. To throw the safeties out.
Oh, a Taiwanese composer. I met her at Eastman School of Music, and she was a unique personality, always saying, "Oh yeah, Garfield, look at me." Anyway, so she has a sense of humor, and she was commissioned by a four-hand piano group to compose something that is audience-friendly. And so she imagined four hands playing, and then thought of four legs too. And together there are eight. And spiders have eight legs, right? So that's the inspiration she had. And so this story came up. And the bugle, the first movement is starting with soft and a little more seconds and some thirds, and so it's a smaller movement. Not so confident yet, the spider, the small spider, is wondering about his identity, and so a little bit of small statement starting in the first part. And then, so the second movement, Tarantella, is a dance, also starting slowly and softly, eventually getting faster and faster and bigger in the register of the piano. And so the spider start to have more confidence. So by the end of the second movement, it's the opposite end of the piano register. And so the spider finally imagines that, oh, I'm really big, like imagining so huge. So third movement, Shadow Warrior, comes into the picture. And Sally said in the program notes that in her workplace in Taiwan, Zhonghua University, there's a building at night because of the light coming through. So if you are somewhere in the light, and the shadow is so huge, like you look so big on the wall of the other building. And so people usually play there. And so that's a scene that she had in mind. And so this spider imagining he's so big. So it's like that. And so the third movement starts finally with such big leaps, and then Spurgeon was in everywhere. So that's how the story evolved in this particular sense.
Thank you.
ballet composed in 1913 by composer Igor Stravinsky. We'll be performing the Four Hands version, which was actually published a year earlier in 1912. It covers all the full score of the ballet. The entirety of the ballet is about 35 minutes long, divided into two parts. The first part celebrates the earth in springtime, covers different paganistic rituals. And second part represents the choosing the young girl to have a sacrifice for the pagan god to please her. And it concludes with a girl dancing herself to death.
Thank you. Thank you.